Hey, what's up guys? Guys, if you're on Trailblazer community, then you might be aware there's a particular section to share an idea over it. An idea could be a feature which is required but not available over the community right now. Users all over the globe are sharing their ideas, suggestions and workaround for those ideas over it. So guys, in today's video, we'll be creating a workaround for one of the suggested idea. The idea was to have default value for a standard field. Let's say if we talk about lead, so the standard field could be the last name and we'll be having the default value for the last name. So guys, if you're planning to create an automation for that, so don't even think about it because I have already wasted my time over it. So we'll be using a URL trick for that, and using the URL trick, we'll be having the default value for a standard field today. Okay, so guys, let's start today's video. I'm Kapil, your host, and you're watching Salesforce Bolt. Alright guys, so let me just show you the idea first. So guys, this is the idea shared on the community, and idea says default value and standard field. The idea has been pending from a long time. As you can see, it's having around 18,000 points and it's been voted by 1817 users, and it's also having 19 merged ideas. So it means there were 19 other ideas also which was related to this idea and that has been merged to this idea. So guys, I will be sharing this ideas link on the description of this video. So please go for it and please upvote it, because I think it could be a good feature and we could expect it in the upcoming release. Okay, so this was the idea guys. So to implement this idea, there was multiple workarounds shared by users over the globe. There are multiple workarounds available, and as you can see, like, everyone is commenting on the idea. It should be required, and there are some other workaround for it. So in today's video, basically we will be creating a URL hack. It's a URL trick basically to have a default value on a standard field in an object. Okay, so let me just show you my object first. And in my objects, standard field will be having a default value there. Okay, so I'm using my existing custom object here. My custom object is zoom data. I have used this object in my previous video, you know, to get the zoom data using the Zapier, if you have watched that video also. So you can just directly go in field and relationship, and let me just show you the field. Yeah, this is. So we'll be using the name field here. As you know, like, this is a standard field with all objects. So I will be having the default value in this standard fields. Okay. So for that guys, you have to create a WhistleForce page for it. All right, let me just show you the VS page. Okay, I have to search for it. Okay, so this is my VF page guys. The page name is lead replacement VF, because I was trying this example on lead first, then I tried it on the custom object also. So let me just save it once. So guys, as you can see in this page, I'm having the standard controller as my custom object, and on the page load, I am just redirecting it to the URL of creating new record, and I'm passing some parameters here. As you can see, I'm passing no override equals to 1. It means it won't override the default screen. You will be getting this VF page as a default screen there. And after that guys, you can see I'm having another parameter which is default field values. So this is the parameter which is going to perform the trick for you guys. So using the default field value parameter, you can just pass variables here. You can just use the default field values equals to your field name and equals to value. It is as simple as that. So, and also guys, you can pass multiple fields here separate. You can also have multiple fields here, and those fields are also having the default value. And I will be sharing a blog for it guys, in which I will be showing you how you can pass multiple fields also. In this example, I'm only passing one field here. Okay, so after creating the VF page guys, you have to override the functionality of new button in your object. So let me show you how you can do that. So you just have to go button links and action and search for the new button, and as you can see, I have already overrided it using my custom VF page. So you can just select the VF page option, and you can select your VF page from here, and you just have to keep all the option as it is. So let's save it once. Okay, so it's saved now, and now let's try it in the org itself. Let me open my object here. So my object was zoom data. Here it is. Okay, so as you can see guys, this is my zoom data page. So let me just create, let me just click on the new button here. So on the click of the new button, we'll be having this same standard screen, but over that standard screen, our Visual Force page will be walking there. Okay, so here as you can see guys, in zoom data name field, we are having a default value tested, which is coming from the Visual Force page itself. So when I'll click on the new button, so it will first redirect the user to the Visual Force page, and from that Visual Force page, it is redirecting us back to this new window screen with the default value here. Okay, so that's how guys, you can just have the default value in all your standard fields. And let's say if you would like to change the default value, so you can use a workflow after it, and you can run a field update, or you can also use a trigger for it. Because if you are having a value here, and before saving, if you are having a value here, so the trigger and automations will be working here. So after the save buttons click, you can just trigger a workflow to rename the field name here. Okay, so guys, that's it for today, and if you learn something new or subscribe to the channel will be awesome. Okay, and don't forget to check out the post on my blog also guys. I will be having the post here. I will be creating the blog on it by tonight, so you can just directly go to that blog and check out the example how you can send multiple values here. Hey, what's up guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button below. Also let me know if you have any query in the comment section below guys. I'll try to revert back as soon as possible. I'll see you in the next one guys. Thanks for watching.